what's up, you guys? It is a beautiful... What day is it?
Wednesday!
And we are driving to go interview Asking Alexandria and Crown the Empire. How are you feeling today, Colton?
I'm tired.
Tired from all the sex you had yesterday?
No.
What are you most excited for?
Oh, I'm excited just to be at another show. Just chill with all the bands, get to know them and everything.
Yeah, hang out backstage, get naked, all that good shit.
I'm excited for all the dick on porn. Bunch of dick.
I've been meaning to get fucking naked, dude.
Excited for all the dick?
A bunch of dick on porn.
There's gonna be so much dick backstage. That's what we're excited for.
Get ready.
Dude, you would be amazed at all the nudity that happens at these shows. It's really amazing. Bands shower, walk around naked. Yes, it's mostly us. You would be amazed at all the dick that we whip out backstage. So I haven't seen Asking Alexandria in like 2 years, and I just know they miss me. Like, honestly, I bet when... No, they don't hate me. I bet as soon as they see me, they just run up and just give me a fucking bear hug.
Oh,
they are just gonna be so excited to see me. I cannot wait, you know. I live for these moments, you know, like, God. I hope Danny just gives me a big kiss right on the lips. It's gonna be a fucking awesome.
Right on the dick.
Right on the dick. My favorite part about, like, our job is we literally look like three homeless people. We get to go backstage and, like, hang out with these bands. It's crazy. Like, a lot of the times, the security guard, even when we have, like, a photo pass, is like, who the fuck are you guys? Like, you should not be back here. And, like, sometimes the band has to be like, no, like, we actually... voice crack. We actually have an interview with these guys. Like, you know, this Aeropostale kid is actually supposed to be here. So, and then I throw Colton in the mix, and they're like, Jesus, what is this transgendered person?
And then they're like, oh, the
transgendered beast.
Because my
the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Everybody's just intimidated by my height.
Yeah, and then when they see Harry, it's like, oh, the Make-A-Wish Foundation must have gotten involved.
Oh, is that boy dying of cancer?
This is his last wish, was to see Asking Alexandria on stage. Last time we were with Asking Alexandria, they showed me how to get a girl. So tonight, after the interview, I am going to go and get
a guy.
There's the tour bus. Is that Asking Alexandria's tour bus?
I think so.
Fuck yes. Dude, Danny Horsnop is in that bus. How do you feel about that?
Dude, your husband is in that bus.
My future ex is in that bus. Dude, I have to pee like a fucking racehorse.
You wanna fuck a racehorse?
What? Alright, guys. After a long and dangerous journey through
Mordor.
Helm's deep.
We have found the Asking Alexandria tour bus. How excited are you, Harry, to meet Asking Alexandria?
I have a huge erection.
Who is that? Is that Ben? I think that's
dude,
Ben.
Ben.
Is that Ben? Yeah. I think that's Ben.
It's Ben, dude!
Hey!
Hi, Ben. How are you?
Ben. I'm hungover as fuck, man. I'm Ben, dude.
See you, man.
It's been a very long time. How are those
Greasy
lessons working out?
Greasy
lessons?
Still don't work. Alright, guy. After a long day of hunting and gathering and exploring with Harry. Hunting. Hunting.
What was your weapon of choice? Crossbow, I hope.
I was hunting.
A straw.
I was hunting for Sam. You know where he is?
Sam?
Yeah, I was hunting for him.
You killed him.
You killed him?
Yeah. Fuck that guy.
Put him in a box.
So we're literally just in like a park.
This is how we're firing him, by the way, this video. When he sees this on YouTube, he's gonna know you're fired, Sam.
Are you guys ready for the interview?
I think so.
I hope so.
Are your boots ready?
I'm not wearing boots.
Wow.
You something's are. On my shoe.
Boots are fucking sick.
Oh shit.
What on my shoe? I think someone took a shit on my shoe or
it's
something.
Rust.
Rust?
It looks like it.
It doesn't.
Alright, here we go. cool. Good luck, guys. Have fun. Don't stress. We're going for a million on this one. I do this for every interview, yeah. You told me you're gonna take me to some strippers tonight, so I gotta, you know.
Woo!
Strip club.
I'm really excited. Woo! Yeah.
Just get my sex move down.
I'm ready.
What do you do?
Asking Alexandria, guys, finally back on the show. Ben, it has been too long.
It has been too long, and Danny's fingers have grown back, so.
Oh, his fingers
grown back.
Yeah,
it's grown back.
That's
so,
good. Yeah. How's old Danny boy doing?
He's good. He's better than he has been in a really long time.
He's moved back to Texas, and I think it's definitely an improvement, so.
Yeah.
He's
a friend again. Woo! Yay! We yeah! like Danny again.
No, but you guys,
nah, I'm kidding. He's
yeah,
kid.
Danny. Dude, I missed you, man. I think Ben is one of the funniest people I've ever met. And you're hungover as shit, right?
I'm hungover as fuck right now. The world feels like it's about to fall out my asshole. No joke. Like, faster than
a
torpedo.
How does that even happen?
What?
How does that even happen?
I don't know. Maybe there's something up there from last night, or it might just be what I put in my mouth. I don't know. It's bad. I do not feel good right now. So I think I should probably just get drunk again.
Yeah, let's just drink more.
Work through it, you know?
That's what you do every day, right? Just keep drinking.
I think it's a borderline problem.
It's just like a cycle, isn't it? Just like a, yeah, well, not vicious.
You
I
thought about
vicious.
Putting
it's
him in
there. Awesome.
Cycle. It's a drunken cycle. It's a good time. My mum's not pleased with me right now. I called my mum last night.
Why do you always do that?
While he's drunk?
Gets wasted and calls people that he shouldn't do, like his sister, his mum. It's like, they don't want to hear me when he fucks up. You know?
I called my mum last night and I vomited on the phone. While she was on the phone, so I know I'm going to call her.
You spewed up whilst on the phone to your mum.
She's
probably convinced that you're like dead or something.
Yeah. Dead or my dad, one of the two.
Yeah, my... I called my mom while I was having an orgy one time.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Was she there? Did you just call call across the room?
I sprint
picked. Having a good time, mom? Me too.
So guys, how does it feel to be arguably the most handsome men on earth?
I wouldn't say it's arguable. I think it is just a fact.
It is a fact.
Yeah.
I feel good right now.
Oh, I don't want to fuck that.
Dude, you're hungover and you still look great.
I know. It's a curse, really. Hottest male in rock, 2 years running at Kerrang. No big deal.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you actually win that?
Yeah, 2 years in a row, man.
Wow. What's your secret?
Evian water.
What is your secret? Is it the boots?
It leaves a radiant glow.
I take these off and I turn into an ogre. But I put them on, I'm golden.
You're like Shrek.
Yeah.
You were wearing those last night when you fell off the stool at the strip club.
It still looks good falling it off, though.
He felt like this. He landed like this.
What do you think the person who discovered milk was doing with the cow?
Wanking it off.
Yeah.
He was just giving it a little suckle and...
He was just thinking like, why does this one have so many dicks?
Yeah. Why does it have so many dicks? Why? But then he put the stuff in his mouth.
Yeah, well, maybe he's used to putting...
Do you not swallow?
Yeah.
What a dick you are.
I just suck him
who
off
spits?
And then
spits?
He's
trying
to
act
yeah. like some classy sort of gal, you know?
Yeah,
everyone swallows,
I'm a classy
Brian.
Head giver.
No, you're not.
Do you swallow?
Yes!
You can yeah.
I sometimes swallow my own and just jerk off and catch it.
You can catch it?
Yeah. It's tasty.
Can you do that, James?
What, jizz in my mouth?
Yeah.
Oh fuck, I can do more than that, mate. I could jizz over my fucking shoulder.
Wow, you think you could hit that window
like,
up there?
Boom, in Ben's mouth.
Yeah, across the bunk. Oh, you know, have you ever been to a mall and they've got those fountains that shoot the water displays? Like, that's me and James across from the bunk to each other.
Wow.
Hey, open wide.
Oh, got it. Oh, that one got my eye, James.
Do you think you could hit that window up there?
I could jizz on that.
Yeah? I could jizz on
that. Sort of like...
Thrust it.
Yeah.
Jizz!
What is your favorite part of the apple?
Of the apple?
Yeah.
Huh. That's weird.
I think
that is weird. Who has a favorite part of an apple? It's all tasty.
I like the first bite.
The first bite?
The first
bite. Do you ever like bite an apple but not so that it comes off in your mouth? There's like the teeth holes and you just suck the juice out?
No.
No, me neither.
Sounds sexual. Yeah,
I don't do
who the Who the hell does that? Yeah,
you look, you go into our bus, there's a fruit bowl, Lewis and Bite Max, and the apples. Like,
he's like, Ben, I just
fucking know who that is.
So, you guys just put out a new album called From Death to Destiny.
It's awesome, by the way.
No, we didn't.
It's Bon Jovi's greatest hits. What? Do your research.
You guys covered every Bon Jovi song. Who came up with the name From Death to Destiny?
Actually, Ash did.
Yeah, I know, I didn't. The owner of it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you think he meant by that?
Well, we know what he meant, and we had a big discussion about it, and basically, during the Reckless and Relentless cycle, he was worried, and everyone was worried, we were going to kill ourselves from drinking too much, too many drugs, blah, 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 blah. Shut up, please.
Yes, ma'am.
We were killing our career, and, you know, now we've matured. And, you know, we've gone from death, the death of the band, to our destiny, which is awesomeness. But if I'm honest, we've always been awesome, so it should have just been called awesome.
From destiny to greater destiny.
Yeah, from destiny to destiny era.
From awesome to fucking awesome.
Exactly. Yeah. I don't...
So, well, the new album, it's definitely...
confused.
James, like, what?
He's like, we should
Destiny era. Should we just call it destiny era?
Destiny era. But this new album... It's different from your previous work.
It is.
Yeah, we've grown up a bit, I think.
Good
yeah, we actually write good songs now.
You guys look a lot older.
Still can't grow a fucking beard.
Except for Ben. Ben still looks...
drunk.
I'm going drunk. That's sort of my problem. I've got grey hairs. That sucks.
So, what would you say is the biggest difference between...
His grey hair.
That's why. That's why I've changed.
Look how many grey hairs he has.
You actually?
Yeah, I know, I'm not fucking lying.
Hold on. Zoo, he actually has gray hair. Yeah, how old are you?
24. He's living with fucking cunts like this.
What? What do I do? I just suck the juice out of apples. I'm a delight.
That gives me gray hair. I want to fucking...
You have gray hair. You
just eat the apple. No.
Dude, are you okay? Like.
Yeah, I'm telling you. I saw the first gray hair and I was like, right, we've got to write a good album now. So we did.
It's got more gray from it. Imagine what the next album will sound like. Johnny Cash or something. He uses is it just for men you use?
Brandon don't use it once.
Just for men. That's brilliant.
Do you guys ever fart on stage?
I farted a few times on stage, I guess.
Yeah.
I think I wouldn't trust it.
No, you know what I mean? Trust your fart?
No, well I don't know, what happens if a bit of shit comes out? And then it's going to get in my drum stool, I'm going to smell it the whole
His thing. Drum stool.
Yeah, I like that. Good one, James. Nice
good.
Yeah.
Good.
Good job.
Finally, a funny.
Padums.
Yeah. Just kidding.
Play that? Because yesterday you fucked up bad.
Hey, we it was smooth as a baby's ass, mate.
I covered it up well.
Yes. Baby's ass are smooth.
If I was on stage, what would have happened? It would have been embarrassing, awkward. We had to stop.
If you weren't on stage, it probably wouldn't have been a very good show, because, you know.
Okay, so Ben, you do fart, though. Do you ever feel, like, guilty that you might have...
Oh, maybe I hope one of the band members runs into it. I just hope they're like, yes. Oh no.
I think farts is something to be proud of, to be honest.
What if you hurt a fan though? What if like they get like
you're welcome. There's a bit of meat in you. Bit of poo particle in your mouth.
They probably like it, right?
Well, exactly. I sell that shit, bottle it up and sell it on eBay. If you're interested.
What would you call it?
Oda Ben. Pink eye.
What's a really dumb name you guys could have named Asking Alexandria?
Bucket of Afterbirth.
Is that a real title?
No, it was... I remember listening to a grindcore band and they actually had a song called Bucket of Afterbirth.
I found a band online the other day and they had a song called Stabbed in the Face Beyond All Recognition. What are you thinking?
It's like they must have literally like brainstormed the worst things ever. Like, how can we just
bucket
make...
Bucket of Afterbirth is the worst.
Oh my god.
You cannot beat Bucket of Afterbirth. Can you imagine that? It's disgusting.
What is...
The centre in there and shit, it would just be so...
What is
it weird that I'm turned on? I don't know, I'm horny.
Which part turns you on? The stabbing of the face or
the smell. I can imagine it. Just
it smells like...
I love that on my genitalia.
Smells like sex and...
Smells like...
That's how we can buy a cum so far.
What person influenced your life the greatest?
James.
I was influencing him. We didn't know each other yet.
How has he influenced you?
Well, if I'm honest, I want grey hairs like him. You know, it's classy look. The silver fox over here. Harrison Ford over here. That's a good look, James.
Gandalf the Grey over here.
There we go, Gandalf the Grey.
That's really turning into a wizard, that's fine.
No, you have to have a beard to be a wizard, and you can't grow facial hair.
We got Dumbledore over here with his staff.
I don't know about Dumbledore.
Dumbledore.
Wait, Dumbledore's gay.
Gay?
So yeah, you could be Dumbledore.
Is he?
Yeah, he is.
In real life?
Yeah. Well, I mean, no, like Dumbledore the character is gay.
Really?
Yeah.
Did what? You get a hard on for Harry Potter?
Where did you get the gay one?
I think that's why he like, you know, matured him through life. Because he wanted him at some point. As creepy as that sounds.
That's a bit fucked up, Brian. Where did you get that from? I read all the Harry Potter books and I got
there was no gay
Dumbledore being gay or any sort of...
I read the uncut version.
Yeah. Dumbledore, paedophile gamer.
Behind the scenes. Of a paedophile wizard. That's a whole...
down in Gringotts.
Once you're in, you never go out. Hogwarts.
Fuck her mind. She is hot though.
What is it like Hogwarts, the secret files or like that?
You're going too far, Brian. It's disgusting. I'm leaving.
I just insulted his favorite book and movie. Everything.
You turned it into a twisted penis.
I'm sorry, guys.
Disgusting!
If your penis could talk, what would it say?
Unicorn.
Unicorn.
First thing that came to mind.
Yeah, unicorn. Mine was, but not mine a gay one. It'd be like one off fucking Cabin in the Woods that fucks shit up.
It's another gay.
Mine would say sit on me or James leave me alone when you're drunk. He gets drunk and I'm lying in my bunk and I wake up to him just fiddling around with my dick. It's weird.
What's going on there, James?
What is going on?
Well, I'm drunk too, so I can't remember it.
Yeah, I can't remember.
I'm not really drunk.
You see the eyes there? You like sipping water, like, oh, man.
I fight him off like this. No, James. No.
Don't do it.
No, James. Don't do
oh,
it.
Stop that,
James. Fish fuck.
See, Ben, this is why I can't pick up girls because.
Because you're gay, like Dumbledore.
Because you're trying to convince them all that their favorite characters are fucking gay.
That's how you have sex.
I try and invite them to Hogwarts. Okay, so. Give me some advice. How do you like? What's a good way to pick up a girl?
It's the best way I know. What's your way? That's what I do.
I just you know.
It's like a fishing hook.
Spring, spring.
Bah! Oh shit.
How do you do it, Jim? I just lure him in with a meatball sub.
Wow, that's not good.
Yeah. What? A meatball sub.
A meatball sub. What?
From Subway.
Just like, hey there. Balls and a fucking hoagie.
Later.
Get on this, love.
So, let me see.
I want to know how he picks up women.
How do you pick up women?
Terribly.
You're not very good at it.
No. Well, I've got one.
You got a girl.
Yeah.
That's
good. I'm stuck with her. I think I've forgotten how to actually. To be honest, I've been with her.
I don't think you ever knew how.
No. It just sort of happens. They come to me.
She just kind of ended up with him.
He's passed out. He'll do for tonight. And then he doesn't let them leave.
What do you guys think is the meaning of life?
Sex.
Sex?
That is the meaning of life, isn't it? You fuck and you reproduce. That's the meaning of life.
What is it? What's that fucking Slipknot album? Which one is it?
Mate, feed, kill, repeat.
Mate, feed, kill, repeat.
That is the meaning of life. They cracked it. Nail on the head.
Mate, feed, kill, repeat. So who do you kill? What do you kill?
You gotta eat some, haven't you?
My sperm, you know it dies as soon as it's ejaculated unless it's in a vagina, so...
I used my sperm to die on a pair of a face or a pair of tits.
He said a pair of feet!
A pair of feet!
Unfortunately though, most of my sperm are predestined to die on my stomach, so... Sorry!
That's where mine will always be.
Yeah, you just pull your waistband of your boxers up and scrape it back down and go to sleep.
I would find that so uncomfortable and you'd be all sticky. What if you roll over and you get it on your fucking phone or something?
So what? You wake up the next day like, I had a good time last night.
With
you did smashing.
How many fans have sexually assaulted you guys? Because, I mean, you have a lot of sex-driven rock and roll.
Yeah, but a lot of our fans are very young, so if they sexually assaulted us, I'd be kind of... disgusted.
Go to your room. Stop it.
I'm going to tell your mother.
Yeah. I don't think we've ever been sexually insulted.
And then tell her.
I will fuck your mother if you don't stop it.
Your daughter was terrible today. She touched my dick while I was playing. Much like this.
better tell her off.
Tell her.
What would you do if, God forbid, you dropped the soap in prison?
I'd stay bent over till someone bummed me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You like it?
Yeah.
Why not?
Why not?
You gotta experiment.
Gotta get something.
Yeah.
There's G-spots in your asshole, man.
They are?
Yeah.
For guys?
Yeah. No, we have like 36 G-spots in our anus, apparently.
Wow.
Apparently. I've only found 34, so it might not be true.
Yeah, it's because you can't reach the other two.
My fingers are too short.
Don't worry, I've got pretty long fingers.
Oh yeah, you're coming to my bunk tonight.
Yeah,
maybe.
So
I knew those groupie lessons worked. They're working on me.
That's right. What would you What would you do? Drop the soap in prison.
Probably kick it around, and make a.
Make a game.
Make a game.
Come on,
let's
naked.
Let's not rape me now. Come on. Please, please, no cocks in my ass.
Not even one.
Oh man.
Maybe one.
What if I was in prison with you?
Well, I suppose as long as you were in there, you couldn't get no one else could be in, so I'd be safe. You on the other hand probably get a fuck, it'd be like a meat train, wouldn't it?
Ben, are you a
a prison meat train.
A train of meat. It's convict train, isn't it?
A train? All aboard the meat train. Ben's the conductor.
Just jerking off at the front.
Shaka, 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 shaka.
Do you reckon if it was long enough, it could make a meat circle? Yeah, just like everyone's gonna, you know,
round in a big circle. Yeah. Yeah, why not? I don't see why not. It's like Lego, innit?
It's like just got a slight turn all
it
the
all
way.
It all fits.
You have to have like 40.
So you have to use like all that math you learned in school, just the angle.
No, I don't learn any maths in school.
Oh shit.
I didn't learn anything in school.
I'll help you.
I got expelled from one of my schools for fucking my girlfriend in the corridor. True.
Really?
Yeah, true.
In the in the hallway?
In the hallway.
You fucked your girlfriend in the hallway.
Yeah.
How old were you?
I must have been about 16.
16?
Yeah.
Wow. And you were fucking your girlfriend in the hallway.
In the hallway. And I guess the cleaner saw us. It was after school.
Oh, I thought it was like during class.
School, so there was people around, but not many. And I guess a cleaner saw us and went and told my head of year and... Yep, I got in trouble.
What did they say when... What was the first thing they said?
Well, they took me into their office and her, and they called both our parents in. And my dad gave me a high five, thought it was brilliant. My mum didn't give a shit. And I got expelled and the girl didn't.
The girl didn't?
Fucking bullshit.
That is discrimination. You should sue them.
She didn't get expelled, so I had to go find a new school to go to. I had to go to a different school. And she got made... head prefect.
That is fucking bullshit.
Yeah, you should.
I guarantee she'd been fucking noshing off the headmaster, hadn't she? That's why she didn't get.
Yeah.
She's doing. Don't expel me, sir.
Don't expel.
I swallow, unlike Brian.
I'm not classy when it comes to this.
I will do anything to stay here.
You can jizz so hard down my throat it comes out my asshole.
What's the most meaningful thing a fan has ever said to you?
One fan told me I had a nice cock, and I took that to heart. I really did. I look at it every day now, and I remind it. No, remember what she said. You're beautiful. Doesn't matter how big you are
beautiful.
How small you are. Yeah, I sing that to it. I sing that to it. It sings back. It's a good time. I love you.
Yeah. Yeah. What did you name it?
Ben. Best name ever.
Ben Jr.
Yeah.
Isn't that great?
No, it's Dover. That way, when I introduce myself to him, I'm like, Ben Dover.
Ben
Done.
You guys, he really enjoys having sex.
Yeah.
He might be the horniest guy I've ever met.
Yeah, it's because he's married and he's been on tour for like, what, a few days now?
Woo!
Yeah, that's...
You got married!
I did get married in May.
How's that?
It's good.
Yeah?
It's good.
I didn't get an invite.
No, I couldn't. You were on tour.
Yeah,
the Brian Stars tour.
Yeah. On a genuine note, you guys seem to connect with your fans more than most bands.
I feel like we do.
Sexually.
Really, you really connect.
I like you, I like you, you're too young, I like you.
No, he's like, you're too young, where's your mother?
Or, I came with my dad. That'll do.
Where's your dad?
As long as he swallows. Yeah.
Why do you guys think your fans love you so much? You really are like worshipped. You're like gods.
Well, you know, I am actually Jesus.
That's it.
I can walk on water.
He looks. Yeah. He looks very good for his age.
He's returned.
There's no holes in my hands either. I'm kidding. I'm real.
I'm real.
Yeah. Can you bless me with a blowjob right now?
I can do. It won't be a blessing. What? I'll bite it off.
Oh my God. I'm hungry.
Why the Oh man, I'm not even going to get into why people believe in Jesus. You're one of those idiots, aren't you? I don't understand it at all. Oh! How is there someone sat up there?
He's just chilling, man.
What doing? What the fuck's he doing? What's he doing?
He's watching everyone have sex.
No, he's not. A pervert, he probably is. Didn't he rape someone? He raped... Who gave birth to Jesus?
Mary.
Mary. Didn't he rape her?
She was a virgin.
Oh, yeah. Clearly. Clearly. He raped her. He did though, didn't he? He came down.
How many times have you read the book?
I've read the book.
Are you a Christian?
Yeah.
Stand, fight back.
There's no fucking point. We've had this argument so many times. Ben even said he's convinced, he's told me that he believed in God before. And now he's going back on his word.
You're going back on your word.
There's something once you die. I don't think you die in your worm food. I think there's something, but I don't believe there's a man in the sky that's like, you've been naughty. Go and spend eternity with my red friend. No, it's fucking wank. That's stupid. It's stupid, isn't it?
Anyway, let's go on to something else. This is going to be like a fucking interview.
He doesn't believe in aliens.
I do.
Do you
think they've come here?
If you woke up on a surgery table and the doc... If you woke up on a surgery...
I'm not listening to you right now. Aliens have been here.
I don't think they have. I believe in them, but they ain't been here.
Okay, you have to leave comments on this YouTube video.
Here?
Yes, that's a lot of letters for yes. Lots of S's at the end. Or do you think they've not been? Am I right? They have been here. Or is James right? They haven't. Yes, but there's a man in the sky, James.
If you woke up on the surgery table and the doctor said, it's done, what would be your response?
Yay, I'm a lady. I can masturbate with lots of things now. Sit on that cone, sit on that pole, sit on you, sit on that mic. I'd find a way to get my gash around this bag.
You think you can masturbate with this bag?
Good times.
That lady isn't you.
She knows what I'm talking about.
She's like, trust me, I've fucked a bag before.
I keep my handbag.
Did you get her? Yeah, some lady walked out. She was laughing her ass off. Literally, her ass was about to fall off.
I'd fuck that too.
Yeah?
Even when I was a woman. Rub it against it.
It's black scissoring, wouldn't it?
Whew. Do you like to dominate or be dominated?
Dominate.
Like to dominate?
Yeah.
Like to take control?
Yep. Physically.
Emotionally?
Yeah.
He hits his girlfriend. She got a fucking split lip last time she was on tour because he hit her.
Oh,
whilst they were
We like it that way. Fucking hell. It's not... I mean...
She likes it.
Yeah.
She wants it.
He chokes her and hits her about. That's far too much effort. I just lie there.
Yeah? No, you can't exert that much energy.
If I'm on top, I use the back of the bed with my feet just to move. Oh, yes. Is this good for you? Because I came ages ago.
You've only been fucking 45 seconds?
Yes. So, I came. I win.
I win. Game over.
Yeah.
I'm done.
Loser. Clean it off.
What life lessons has touring taught you?
How to fuck.
How to fuck
and how to drink.
How to fuck while drinking.
How to fuck whilst drinking without spilling it.
Hey. I think it would be, wouldn't it be, how to fuck while, yeah, drink whilst fucking, sorry.
How to drink while fucking.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you reversed
it. How to fuck whilst drinking, because we don't stop drinking.
Just drinking, right. I need some fucking to come right now. Just do it.
You'll do.
Whoa.
That's what touring is.
You guys must have so much fun out there.
It's a good time.
You know, this whole thing... I remember like 3 years ago, no one gave a fuck about you guys.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. Lot, man.
So like, is it weird to like have gotten this big this fast?
I've been pumping it a while now. The extra inch.
Still pretty insignificant.
I thought you had a 1-inch dick, it's blue.
Yeah, but now it's 2 inches.
I just stepped in gum.
I stepped in gum last night on stage. It wasn't there the whole set, because it was by my pedal. Someone must have thrown gum at me whilst I was playing. What, because towards the end of it, I was like... Fuck, it was horrible. It pissed me off.
What's it like to be on stage every night? Is it fun?
Fuck
yeah. Great when there's no gum.
Fuck.
It's gonna be interesting tonight because the stage is rather small.
Small stage.
Hey, intimate, more in time. Together.
I mean, it's fine for me. I've still got my fucking huge drum riser. It's just wounded for these guys.
James.
Mr. on his high horse. Yeah, over there, literally.
Yeah. Well, it's funny because you're up there on your pedestal when you're the one that fucks up the most.
Fuck off. No, I do not. I actually fuck up the least. It's very noticeable when I fuck up because...
Because the song stops. We stop playing. Dick.
Because the whole song stops.
Everything fucks up. It's like when I fuck up, it's like a catalyst. The whole fucking thing.
Fucked up yesterday and managed to get back in. It's like, oh, yes, nope. Fucked up again. We had to stop it. It was terrible. And then once he stopped for about 5 seconds... Looked at me and I was still playing. You tried to come back in with it again. It was embarrassing.
You're an embarrassment to asking Alexandria.
Fuck no, I'm not an embarrassment.
You've got grey hair, you believe in Jesus, you beat women while you fuck them, and you can't play drums.
Why are you still...
Do you just, for this interview, when you upload it, just have a big black bar here. Just a big sensor bar over James moving as he moves.
Put a picture of Justin Bieber or Harry Styles.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Someone with some talent on the drums. Have you seen Justin Bieber play the drums? It's phenomenal.
This motherfucker is such a shit guitarist. He's taking the piss out of me. He can fucking suck my dick.
Yeah, but I can fuck whilst drinking.
So can I. And I can be rough about it whilst I'm doing it.
Doesn't count.
If Danny had erectile dysfunction, what would you say to encourage him?
I would not encourage him. I'd take the piss out of him. I would get a boner and walk around naked everywhere he was. Hey, man.
Just nudge him with it, you know.
Look get this what I can do. Does it make you sad? That's what I would do.
You just use it to point out stuff like, Danny, have you seen that?
Oh my god, look over there! And here!
It's like a market, you know? Like, just trying to get,
you get your keys.
Danny.
Get your keys.
Nope, it's not slapping my legs because it's hard.
Who were you in a past life and what did you do? I think
I was
Moses.
I was James and I killed myself because it sucked. It was shit.
You got gray hair at 24.
I got gray hair at 24.
You beat women.
I beat women. I was ugly.
This interview is just steadily turns and fucking going at me. Fuck this. Fuck you, Brian.
I'm just kidding.
Fuck you.
Fuck you and fuck your cat.
Fuck you and your shit.
Fuck your cat.
Fuck my cat.
Do you have a cat?
Yeah, no. I should get one now. And name it Muffins.
Yeah, no, I don't. Do you have a cat? Yeah, no.
Yeah, that was a lie. It was a lie.
That was a lie. If you could name the next Justin Bieber album, what would you name it?
This is my last one. You're welcome.
I've already made enough fucking money, thanks.
Yeah, man. It must be...
Suckers.
You think it's fun to be Justin Bieber?
Fuck yeah, it's fun to be Justin Bieber. I watched a YouTube video of him the other day driving his... What's that car he's got? Is it a Lambo or a Ferrari or something?
Something disgustingly awesome.
And someone was like filming him and said, they were filming this and he was driving like a piece of shit. So this guy's like wound down his window. He's like, stop driving like a dickhead. It doesn't matter who you are, blah, blah, blah. And Justin Bieber went, put the handbrake on, just sat in the road in his car. All the traffic had to stop. He was like, I'm not fucking moving. And he just sat there.
What a
But you would, wouldn't
you? If you've got enough money, it's like, well,
dude,
fine.
He's Justin Bieber. He can do whatever he wants.
Right.
I mean, I would do
Would he fuck whilst drinking, do you think? Is he old enough to fuck or drink?
he's like 15, right?
No, he's
older than that now.
He has more tattoos than you guys now.
Get out.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't.
His arm is covered now.
Really?
Yeah, he's covered. No, I'm serious. Yeah, he's got a lot of tats.
Justin Badass.
Trying to go for the edgy. His next album's gonna be a little bit metal, you know.
His next album's gonna have a little screaming, a little hardcore.
I hope so.
Yeah. A lot of screaming girls throw themselves at you. Do you ever catch them?
No.
Just let fall.
Danny's caught a few things off him though. It's not true. It wasn't a few, it was a lot.
Some permanent.
Some that will never go away.
Fucking baggage for life.
Yeah.
A kid.
When he checks into the airport and they ask how many bags.
A lot. A lot. He's overweight every time. That's a lot of extra. That's why this band is broke. We have to pay for his luggage every time we fly anywhere. Disgusting.
James, describe yourself in three words positively.
Oh, no. That's good. Yeah, absolutely. Fucking
hideous is what came to mind for me.
Three words sexually. Open.
Oh, oh, oh. Ready, set, came.
What motto?
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
No, Mum, I'm not drunk. Sorry. No, I won't drink again today. Promise. No, I'm not drinking now. Love you. I don't know what happened. My mum called, sorry.
What motto or quote do you live by? Your mom, actually, yeah. Let's go back to that. Your mom must be so
proud.
What motto or quote do you live by?
What motto?
Mine is like, money, liquor, hose.
Mine's seize the cunt.
Seize the... seize the cunt.
That's fucking hideous. Seize the cunt. It's just like, yes!
Seize the clunge.
Mine is live by the gun, die by the gun.
That's kind of cheesy, I'm not going to lie.
That's American as fuck. Yeah.
I wish an eagle just flew down right now with the American flag in his talons. Pow, 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 pow! America!
He's flying, he's just got a banner saying freedom or some shit. Justice!
Obama's
riding it. I love you, Brian.
You're the fucking man.
Seize the cunt.
Yep.
What would yours be, James?
I don't know. I'm still picturing Obama on the eagle now.
Horror, horror, want more?
Horror, horror, want more?
Yeah. Horror, horror, want more.
I don't really know.
Spank me, I like it.
He said, horror, horror, oh, I want more.
Horror, horror, want more.
Horror, horror, want more.
Horror, I want more. That's what he said.
That's what she said.
Or.
Or.
Want
that's your new motto, but you have to say it in the American.
Or. Want more. Or.
Why does that sound like you got a cock in your mouth when you say.
No, I can't do an American accent.
Visualize.
Is that the sound of it?
What Disney character best describes you in the bedroom?
Belle. Because she's hot as fuck. Who doesn't want to fuck Belle, let's be honest?
That's true.
And fucking...
Really? It's okay.
Never seen Pocahontas?
John Smith?
Yeah.
You would be... Okay, sorry, I was distracted. I saw an eagle.
Danny's definitely got Woody with his erectile dysfunction, isn't he?
I think I would be Buzz Lightyear. Because I take them to the moon.
Oh.
I take them to infinity and beyond.
But he doesn't really, does he? He just thinks he does. So yeah, I guess it's fitting.
He thinks he's
fitting.
He thinks he's real.
Away thinking
he's like you're welcome.
Love that. She's like,
you're welcome.
She waits till he's gone. Jig.
Finishing him off.
Yeah, he thinks
he's over and gets the vibrator out. Brian's gone. Yep.
And gets the backpack.
Yeah, exactly. Just shakes it around in there for a bit.
I take him to infinity and beyond. I feel, what would James be? James would be...
Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Why is that man so mean to me?
Oh, man. So, from death to destiny,
I'd be Slinky Dog from Toy Story.
I'm gonna put this out there. We are steadily moving closer and closer to this car.
Yeah, I'm getting tired.
You're like,
car alarm goes off. Fuck!
Peace. We are getting close. Wait, was this car always here?
Yes, no, we started off, no shit like this. and we're like gradually moving over there. Like, what if we just, we're just gonna be like stood
there
why? Where people
because I'm on this side and everything's gravitating towards
yeah,
me.
Yeah, because you just keep moving. He's like talking and moving around.
You're the one that I want. You're the one that I want. Mm. What if we just like gradually like kind of ended up like here? Just like
on the fence. Yeah. In the
dumpster. Just inside the dumpster.
Just on it. Just clip to it.
Did you ever get punished as a child?
Ben never did. You can tell. That's why he's an asshole now.
Oh, I got punished. My parents got divorced. That was punishment enough, James. Thanks for bringing that up.
Typically, we bring that up.
Yeah, Ben. God. No, James, you asshole. I thought you were a...
I'm from a broken home, man.
I thought you were a Christian.
Throw that in my face, yeah. You... That's how Christians behave, I guess.
Fuck you
making,
guys.
Making fun of homeless children.
Homeless? You never said he was fucking homeless. Where'd you get that from?
I was homeless.
How the fuck's
my
sake?
Parents got divorced because my dad raped me, okay? I lived on the
by
street.
By a priest.
My dad raped me by a priest. My dad came in with a priest and just forced his cock Where's into
Ben?
Me.
Ben, get here!
Get my son, priest! Fuck you, that's why I don't believe. Too many painful memories in my anus.
That is fucking horrible. I can just picture your dad with a priest now.
A lot of our viewers say they get bullied for being metal or, I don't know.
They get bullied by fucking losers then.
Yeah, what advice would you give them?
A swift kick to the nuts. And if they're a woman, a quick punch to the tit.
Yeah.
Who cares? Anti-bullying, kick the shit out of them.
Yeah.
Your music's gay.
Oh!
Not gonna make fun of you again, is he?
Yeah. Absolutely.
And if he does, it's with a slightly higher pitched voice.
You're gonna piss blood for a week!
Fuck you! People equal shit.
Oh man. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah?
Why do you think I like older women?
You can't get chicks your own age, so you thought you'd go for some old broke
woman. It's the woman that sat at the bar just so miserable. Brian.
My husband's left me. Hello. I'm Brian.
I'm Brian Starr.
I have a tour, you know. And she goes, oh, I could fuck bands. Best sleep with him first, so I get on tour.
Yeah, and if they don't have teeth, they get really good kisses.
Yeah.
Three
kisses on the toesies.
Yeah, they suck your toes really well. Yeah.
All of them.
At once.
Yeah. Devouring a lollipop.
Not so good at chewing carrots though. Yeah.
Give her a chocolate bar, it takes a while.
Just melts.
If you describe your sex life with a movie title, what would you choose?
Mine would... Top Gun.
Top Gun.
Everything with Top Gun. Everything in James's life is Top Gun. It's not though, is it?
I like Top Gun. It's a good film.
I would be
The Borrowers.
Mine would be Toy Story.
You're just all on Toy Story right now with the Buzz Lightyear.
There's a lot of toys involved in my sex life.
But no women. Absolutely no women.
Do you have any love advice for people?
What?
What?
That's it. Run away from it.
What happened?
It's a bug, man.
Oh, Ben's obviously very brave.
Well, I saw someone, a kitten stuck in a tree, and it was drowning.
Some people
saved it from the fire.
Did your parents or grandparents ever have any funny proverbs? Like, Mai was always told, every once in a while, a blind squirrel finds an acorn.
I suppose it would find one eventually, right? Would?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, because if you think about it, if it's gone blind, its sense of smell is heightened, so it will just sniff it out.
Acorn a mile off.
Its dick is larger, yeah.
No, its dick's not larger, Brian.
Oh. I'm a blind squirrel.
Blind squirrels don't have bigger dicks.
Did you have any proverbs you were taught as a child?
Blind squirrels don't have bigger dicks. Yeah, that's what. Yeah.
Touch it at least 3 times a day, and you'll be successful.
What is the secret to success?
Sucking the juice out of apples. Obviously, yeah.
I work really hard and
you
treat
don't suck
people.
Enough apples.
Huh?
You don't suck enough apples.
But obviously. I work really hard and treat people well, and I'm not I'm not getting anywhere in my life, so...
You have a tour, man.
I have a tour, you're yeah.
Hanging out with James Cassells, and former drummer for Asking Alexandria.
Did you ever try and change for a person?
No. Fuck it. You change for me, bitch.
Literally, change.
Yeah, seriously, yeah, your outfit's horrible. You look like shit today.
Your
babe.
Ass does look
put
fat.
Put some new
now.
Clothes on.
Fucking put some else
yeah.
on.
Yes, those jeans make your ass look fat. Change.
You think you'll be a good parent? You guys?
I do.
Yeah?
Yeah, because.
Kind of dad will you be?
I don't think I'm be a good though.
What are you talking about? My child, if it's crying, give it some booze. Fast asleep. If it's teething, give it some booze. Fast asleep. If it's awake, give it some booze. Fast asleep. It's easy.
Give it some booze.
Fast asleep, covered in shit. Wait till mom cleans it up later. It's easy.
What about when they're older and they like need guidance?
Give it some booze, having sex. So easy.
What about when they're coked out in some rehab center?
Give them some more coke, bring them home. What? It's. I don't understand how people can mess this up. It's fairly straightforward.
Hi right, guys, let's pretend that we are starting a boy band. You ready? Let's make our album cover.
Why are we doing this? If it's an album cover, why are you breathing?
In the mirror, he's just like, yeah, boy.
But why are you breathing if it's an album cover? They can't hear
you. I'm just so turned on. I'm just so turned on
by my nipple?
By the thought of this.
Got our nipples out.
Hold on, Pond and Brain Body's calling. Can I take this real quick?
No. So, I have a tour. I'm Brian Stars. I'm on the phone like an asshole.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm sorry, man.
Moo.
I talk about cocks a lot and shit like that.
Toy Story. Because toys. I like my nipple.
I like pedophile wizards.
I love how you lean into the mic.
I know,
mic.
I need to get right there.
Wizards, fuck kids. I don't know how to wield a microphone.
Like this. Mmm, yeah.
Just have it for like a holster.
Okay,
like
okay, yeah. We'll just talk about the number set and everything.
Yeah. Right, people look shit. Are you back?
I am. What did you guys do while I was gone?
Nothing.
Yeah? That's
you
good.
Smell your mic. It's not been in my arm.
It's been in mine.
Yeah.
How are you guys in general so positive all the time when a lot of people struggle to do that?
Because we're always drunk.
Yeah, lots of booze.
Lots of booze, man.
Because we're always drunk.
It's the way forward.
Are you guys ever sober?
No.
Are you sober right now?
No.
No. What is your favorite sex position? Like, you know how they have names? Mine is the Korean chainsaw.
Oh yeah, how does that go?
You get three Korean women, and you dress them up in pink bunny costumes, and you get out a chainsaw, and just use your imagination.
I don't like that one.
So what, you just... You
get, it's not
you get
run,
it
out it's
and
not,
it's a new one, it's shiny,
not
you're just showing
though.
The Korean women.
Yeah,
just,
you just
look
show
at this awesome fucking tool I have now, it's great. Dude, and then they suck you up.
I feel like this question's unfair because I'm married. This is what my sex life looks like. I'm in bed right now, sat up, playing on my phone. Hey, babe, you, no? No. You sure? No? No. Oh, she's asleep. Yes. That's my position.
Have you ever met a fan who self-harms?
Yes, lots of them.
They shouldn't do it.
Yeah.
It's never an option, I think.
Oh, it's not. I don't even have a joke about this one.
Yeah, like, there's no joke on that one, yeah.
I don't understand why, what could happen to lead someone to get that way, but, you know, just, there's always positives to look at, you know. Like you said, we're always positive. Shit happens in life, and I think, you know, you can find someone or something to help. Whether it's music or a parent.
It's never helping, you know, self-harming. It's never like making anything better or it's just something you shouldn't do.
Do you feel good that your music has, you know, saved lives and maybe helped? You ever get, has people hand you razor blades, right? Has that happened to you before?
No.
No.
No one's handed me a razor blade.
I can't imagine.
Who's been handing you razor blades, mate? Maybe they're telling you something. Kill yourself.
Have Vance told you that you saved their life, though?
Yeah, and that's one of the main reasons we do this, you know? Mm-hmm. It's nice to be able to help someone. Something that we do and we love and we enjoy. If it can relate to someone and help them, fuck yeah, man.
What has been the most challenging thing you guys went through?
Puberty. I'm still struggling with it. I can't grow a beard.
Between these two albums, what was the most challenging thing?
Not fucking falling apart to pieces as a band.
Yeah.
There was a lot of times when, after certain tours, we were like almost spent and just like, are we going to fucking continue doing this? Or just like making it through, you know. Now we're obviously in a great place, but yeah. There was definitely been some highs and lows in between these two albums.
So what does Asking Alexander mean to you guys? Is it like?
It's everything. It's my life. It's my passion, my hobby. It's all I know, you know. There's nothing else I could picture myself doing. There's nothing else I ever want to do.
What have you learned from Danny Warsnop?
That showering is a vital part of life.
Personal hygiene.
And
you should
do it more.
Yeah. Integral part of life.
Yeah, I like that.
That's about all I've learned from Dan.
Don't wear cowboy boots without socks.
Wear underpants.
Wear condoms.
Yeah. No.
Hello, I'm Bon Jovi. This is
Gary Glitter.
Gary Glitter, nice choice.
I know.
We have a new album coming out. Actually, it just came out of the closet. It's gay and it's proud. It's called From Death to Destiny.
Wear the colours. Hi.
What?
Gay colours.
Oh, the gay pride rainbow.
Yeah, rainbow.
Do it.
Wear it.
Wear it. Even if you're not gay, just support the movement. You know, it's about time these people get a bit of joy in their life and don't have to hide behind wooden doors anymore. You know, they're out, they're free doing their thing. They're probably buying our album, if I'm honest. You know, it's for everyone. Gays, Christians, non-Christians, Brian, you. So, do it. For the children.
Have you heard of 50 Shades of Grey? James,
yes,
I'm sure.
Yes. It's a sex book, right?
It's a sex book. Mm. I have a couple of excerpts.
I haven't read it, by the way, so.
Alright.
Alright, he's going to read it.
You're going to read the first one. Do the second one
James
right here.
I can't read. This is putting him on the spot.
Alright. Just read. I want you to read it like you're. There's a group of school children, and you're just...
Like I'm reading sex fiction to a group of school children. You really are wanting to be this Dumbledore guy, aren't you?
No, I'm just kidding.
It's all coming out.
Like, a group of older... Okay, it's made for moms. So just pretend there's like a bunch of moms right here, and you're trying to get them off. Second paragraph. Here we go.
You're so deliciously wet. God, I want you. He thrusts his finger inside. I cry out as it. Yeah, I know, because I.
Women on.
Turn them on.
Should I tell you how I would turn them on?
How?
I'll show you.
You're so deliciously wet. God, I.
I'm gonna try and pick you up with Justin Bieber lyrics. Are you ready? Ben, your world is my world. And my fight, it's your fight.
This is why you're single.
All right, guys, Asking Alexandria, it has been an absolute ball dropping.
Lots of balls.
Lots of balls.
Lots and lots of balls.
James, thank you so much. Let's finish, guys, with. We just saw the new One Direction movie.
Oh, have you seen it?
It's coming out soon. We got a sneak preview.
Is it good?
It's amazing. We saw it. It's amazing. And now we're coming out of the theater, and they want to take a picture in a photo booth of us three. Ready? We're 16-year-old girls.
Okay.
All right. This is how we're going to finish. One, two, three. Yeah! That's what makes you beautiful.
All right, guys. So asking Alexandria is about to go on stage.
Colton, are you excited?
Oh hell yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh shoot. Danny, how you doing, buddy?
Sick, but I'm ready to go. I'm ready to rock, same as always.
Looking good as usual.
Oh. worry, there's plenty more where that came from. Come with me behind the scenes, backstage, and onto the tour bus to meet your favorite stars. Hey, what's up, you guys? We're hanging out here with Asking Alexandria, the very tired all-time low. You're hanging out here with Black Veil Brides. I'll ask questions you've never heard before and get you the answers you won't find anywhere else. You said you're a Justin Timberlake fan.
No.
No?
No.
Maybe that wasn't you?
My God, I shouldn't have smoked all that weed.
How long is this nose you have here?
I have no idea.
Happy birthday, dear bride.
I am a ninja.
You need to know.
What's that?
If you were a porn star, what would your name be?
Mine would definitely just be the Jackhammer.
Our new song, you know, right?
Party like it's...
Oh, God.
Like,
my balls, yeah. You guys see my balls? You know, and they're like, whee!
All right. I'm like crying.
He's crying.
Thumbs up, comment, and subscribe for brand new videos every day. Reporting for YouTube, I'm Brian Stars.
Brian Stars! Brian Stars!
I'm the reason you go on tour.
You're the reason I'm here, baby.